Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Edmund Swarovski to perform his new arrangement entitled Moon River.
It's been a long time since my very first performance on this stage. Hundreds of performances, thousands of hours of rehearsals, millions of audiences. I wonder that how many challenges I have faced and overcome to get here, to this position where I am today. Who can know the difficulties and obstacles that once lay in my path to reach this great success that I so enjoy now. Today, I shall share with you some details of my life so that others like you will learn from my example and find the courage to follow your heart's desires even when faced with unbearable pressures. Follow me now. Follow me back in time. Back 7 years ago, back at my old high school.
Years ago, when Edmund was just a little teenager, he was just a boy who loved to play music. He practiced at school every day, but he had a secret, his biggest secret of his life.
Well done, Edmund. That's totally perfect. Now, you can move on to this new song. No, you have to more syncopation, accent, attack, your feeling. Yes. Oh, I nearly forgot. I've got an invitation for you.
It's a what?
It's an invitation from the Yamaha Electron International Competition.
Do I have to go, Mr. Steve?
Yes, you do.
But I... Not really sure I want to go.
But you must go. This is your chance. You will compete from the people around the world.
Are you sure is it a good idea?
Just do it. I promise you will love it, okay? Here is the registration form. Read it and let your daddy sign it here, okay?
Okay,
that's enough
Mr.
for today. You're dismissed.
Goodbye, Mr. Steve.
Goodbye. Don't forget to let your dad sign it, okay?
Sure, Mr. Steve.
Edmund walks away with a worried face. He now faces a problem. His father doesn't even know that Edmund is attending music school. His father thinks that Edmund is studying political science at a business school. How can Edmund get his father to sign the form for the Yamaha International Electone Competition when his father doesn't even know he can play the electone? Edmund's heart is heavy with gloom.
Oh, I'm home, Rowan. Where are you? I need to talk to you.
Hi, Ed. Whoa, what's wrong, Ed? Why do you look so depressed?
I think I have a problem, Rowan.
Hey, sit down. Take it easy, okay? Sit down.
Mr. Steve want me to compete the Yamaha Electron Competition. And I need my dad's signature, Rowan. He'll find out, Rowan. He'll find out I've been lying to him.
Yeah, Dad. I told you. Just relax, okay? You know what he's like.
But he'll read the form first.
He never reads anything yet. I told you. Just relax, okay?
Are you sure, Rowan? Are you really sure he won't find out I'm in music school?
Hey, trust me. I'm your brother, right? Just relax, okay?
Thanks, Rowan.
Edmund, feeling much better after hearing his brother's advice, walks bravely into his father's room. His father, as always, is sitting in his favorite chair and reading his favorite newspaper.
What the devil? Oh, it's you, Edmund, my eldest son. It is too hard to knock before you enter.
Oh, I'm sorry, my daddy. I just think that I would come and see you.
What do you want now? More money?
No, nothing like that.
So what do you want?
Daddy, I just want you to sign the...
Edmund, my dearest son, it's so happy to see you.
Oh, hi, mommy.
How's middle school, my boy? Studying hard?
Yes.
Politics and business isn't an easy subject to study. But let me tell you how deeply proud I am of you. Do you know that?
We are so deeply proud of you, Edmund. Now look at your father, a handsome, powerful man with lots of money. You're going to be just like your father one day, right?
Yes.
So what do you want?
Daddy, I just want you to sign this form. It's from the business school.
What is it?
It's nothing really. Just sign it, Daddy.
What the devil?
What does it say?
It says that Edmund is going to an Electron International competition. And it is from a music school.
Edmund, have you been lying to us?
He has, the little frog. Edmund, tell me this is a joke.
I'm so sorry, my dearest parents. I didn't mean to offend you. But I must follow my heart, and music is my life.
You fly to us.
How could you, Edmund? How could you do this to us?
I gave you the opportunity to go to a business school. But then you lied to us and go to a wolfy music school.
How could you, Edmund? How could you do this to us?
Get out of this house, you pansy neo-liberal ass cupcake!
Please, Daddy, don't do this to me! I just want to be a musician!
You have brought shame to this family. Out of this house!
Please, Daddy, no! Please!
Edmund walks out of the house and with no home to go, crying and feeling desperate. It seems that now he has no future at all. How can he be a musician without studying at a music school and with no money from his father? But then, suddenly, he remembered the only person in the world who could understand and help him, Mr. Steve. He runs to his teacher's house and knocks on his door.
Oh, Edmund, it's you. Why do you come here? Come in.
My parents have thrown me out of their house and I don't have money to go to music school anymore.
How could this happen, though? I thought that your family appreciated your hard work.
Well, I didn't tell them that I was in music school because my daddy thought that I was in business school.
So why didn't you tell him first?
I couldn't. My daddy want me to be just like him.
He want your life to be better than this. You are, okay?
No, he didn't.
Remember, Edmund, don't ever judge a single second of your heart. Let go of your dream. If you don't have a dream, you won't have a dream come true.
Oh, yeah. Whatever, Mr. Steve. I have to go now. I have to sleep in the cold, dark park tonight.
In the cold, dark park?
Yeah, where else can I sleep now?
Yeah, where else?
Goodbye, Mr. Steve. Thanks for your help.
All right. Wait. Are you sure that you are going to live alone in a cold, dark park? I can't allow that. It will be too cold. Take this old newspaper with you. It will keep you warm in it, okay? No. Okay, like this.
Thanks, Mr. Steve. Good night.
Goodbye, Edmund.
Once again, Edmund finds himself desperate and alone. As night approaches, he is sitting on a park bench, and the only protection he has between him and the wild dangers of the dark twilight world is a newspaper given to him by his trusted teacher, Mr. Steve. However, Edmund soon finds himself at the mercy of the criminal world when some lawless girl gangsters decide to check him out.
Why are you sitting on my bench?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Who are you looking for? Are you looking for someone? Are you looking for me, honey? What do you want here? You don't belong here. This is our time, honey. Beat it.
I'm calling the police.
It's my newspaper.
Give us your money.
I don't have any money.
Then you should find some for us.
Do you wanna be in our gang? So we're not good enough for you, huh?
I didn't say that.
Don't you like us, sugar boy? You think you're better than us, don't you, hunky man?
Hey, but I didn't say that.
So, do you want to be in our gang, right?
Okay. I'll be in your gang.
Hey, you can't just be in our gang. You must prove yourself first.
Oh, okay, yeah, whatever.
Hey girls, Sweetie Pie wants to be in our gang.
Well, but you have to get something for us first, lover boy. You've got to bring us some present, Mr. Cutie. You see those people walking their dogs in the park? Well, you have to steal a thing or two from them.
But they won't know a thing.
Okay, you want me to be a pickpocket?
Not picking their pockets, sweetie. Their watches, low leg watches. Look, there's someone coming, girls.
Edmund knows that he now must face another challenge. He cannot believe how his circumstances have changed in such a short time. Now he has to be a thief for a bunch of girl gangsters. Edmund must use his stealth and wit to good effect.
Oh, hi there! It's a beautiful evening, isn't it?
Are you talking to me?
I said it's a beautiful evening, isn't it?
What?
Oh, nice dog you have there.
Hey, be careful, it bites.
Hey, hello, little doggy. Oh.
Hey, oh. I told you it bites.
Bit my hand. What time is it now?
It's half past the evening, I guess.
Oh, look at the stars. It's shining brightly in the velvet sky.
Ooh, so beautiful.
Yeah, so many stars.
Yeah. Hey, what the devil? Hey, Doc, slow down. Hey.
Well done. That was so cool. You're so masterful. We'll keep it with the other stolen watches. You're now a member of our girl gang. Congratulations.
Look at all our stolen stuff now.
Hey, what is that noise?
Stay where you are, this is the police.
Keep your hands where we can see them.
Do not attempt to resist arrest.
Get down on the floor.
Keep your hands where we can see them.
Are these the ones, sir?
Yes, these are them. Well, he is anyway.
Look, here's the stolen stuff. Is it your watch, sir?
Oh, yes, it is. Thank you, officer.
Is this boy who stole it, sir?
Yeah, that's a little criminal. What about these girls?
He made us do it, officer. I'm just a sweet little girl, officer. Officer, my mommy and daddy are worried about me. We need to go home. It's past our bedtime.
He stole all our things. We just a cute little girl playing in the park. He let us go, officer. Please, let us go. He let us go.
Hey, don't listen to them. I just did what they said.
They're just sweet little girls playing in the park, officer. This nasty boy is the mastermind.
Okay, the girls can go.
Let's just leave this disgusting pair evil thought.
You're coming with us, little boy. You are going to jail.
Hey, let me go. I'm just a poor boy from a poor family.
That's enough. You committed a crime.
You will get a 20 years in jail for this.
No more girls or Rolexes for you, you immoral frog.
Edmund finds himself desperate and alone. Now he can only contemplate the bizarre circumstances that brought him there, and his so very fiendishly terrible and despicable future.
Prisoner 102, Secret 01, you have visitors.
Edmund?
Oh, Mr. Steve, I'm so glad to see you.
Yeah, your friend told me everything about that cold dark heart, about that girl gangster, about your father, about the electron, about everything. I couldn't just leave you here.
Thanks, it's Mr. So Steve.
Edmund, I want you to know one thing.
What is it?
We all need someone to catch up when we fall down.
Do you really mean that?
And one day, someone will come and help you. Look, your brother Rowan is here. He has something to talk with you.
Edmund? Rowan! Oh, I'm so glad to see you.
Ed, just relax, okay? Take it easy. Okay?
Hey, thanks, Rowan.
Everything gonna be alright. Trust me, I'm your brother, right?
Thanks, Rowan.
Edmund! Daddy has sent me to let you out of the jail. Now he is very angry with you. He doesn't want to see your face. Warden, come here.
What the devil do you think you're doing?
Let him go free.
Sir, I cannot just do that. He committed a crime.
Just read this, Warden. Read it.
I'm sorry, sir. Son Swarovski-san. I'm just doing my duty.
So, let him go now.
It's an honor to serve you, sir.
Hurry up, we will be late.
Late for what?
The electron competition.
What? We must go now.
Ladies and gentlemen, our last contestant, entry number 7, Edmund Swarovski. Where is he? Edmund Swarovski. Oh, where is he? Edmund Swarovski. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, that's all for tonight. Thank you for joining us today, our Yamaha. Oh, there he is, Edmund Swarovski. Ladies and gentlemen, entry number 7, Edmund Swarovski. Thank you. without...
Yeah, that was tough.
Yes.
Running up.
Yeah.
What the devil?
Edmund, what a beautiful sound.
Edmund, your music has brought tears to my eyes.
Daddy, mommy, oh, I'm so glad to see you.
Where did you learn to play like this, son?
Your music has brought tears to my eyes.
It's not me, Don Swarovski. I'm still quite your call.
You will be rewarded for this, Mr. Steve. Edmund, you are a disgrace to this family, and you were sent to jail. Why didn't you want to be like me? How can I know?
Daddy, I just want to be a musician.
I know you have talent, and I accept you are a wonderful musician.
Please, don't say sorry, Daddy.
I don't say sorry to anyone, but I have a surprise for you, Edmund.
What is it, Daddy?
Tonight, on this great occasion, I have a surprise, Edmund. You can have a lifetime music course with Mr. Steve.
Yes! But Daddy, how about the police and my jail sentence?
Don't worry about that. I made them an offer they couldn't refuse.